Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Metroid Fusion for the Game Boy Advance. Last time, we went and activated the auxillery power, which only powered up recharge and save stations, which is good for us because it means less checkpoints issues to deal with. But on the other hand, we can't really access other sectors or rooms without, you know, the main power being back on. So, yeah, we're kind of in a shitty predicament right now. So, let's use our newly acquired space jump and see what we can find and discover within these walls here, because, yeah, having the space jump on hand really allows us so many possibilities of finding new and secret areas and shit. Oh, okay. Okay, I'm not patient enough to sit there and place forkball bombs for every single one of those, fuck that. Oh. Is that what I think it is? Oh god! But now you get to actually see it, what a real Say-X like chase looks like, because now we're actually forced to engage. And we certainly don't have the tools to fight this thing! Don't let this thing freeze you. Don't. Then it's just a death wish waiting to happen. You know, it can go into morph ball form. I mean, we clearly saw that back in Sector 6, so, like, I wonder why it didn't really have the brains to, like, go through here and check and see what's behind here, because that would have been the perfect strategy to murder me in my sleep. Alright, so we're back in Sector 2, and as I said before, you usually visit every sector in this game twice, except for Sector 5, which you visit 3 times for some reason. So, basically what I'm saying here is that outside of the stuff we need endgame tools for, now that you have a lot of new tools and weapons in your arsenal, I would definitely take care to be sure and find every, like, expansion you can while you're still here, because we won't be coming back to this sector, like, ever again. Outside of, well, you know, endgame collections and shit, so. Yeah, already starting to run into familiar territory here. I love how all of these hatches just happen to be conveniently open for us. Either way, though, it does kind of limit where we can and cannot go, so that's a bit shitty, so. Yeah, let's keep in mind of where those set hatches are so we can check them out later. I need that save room. Thank you very much. Ow. Fuck yourself. Gonna check out that room a little bit later, but first let's go over here. As our target isn't too far off. There either. Not really an option for us at the given moment, so what's going on here? Okay, so we know that thanks to our map hints here that we need to find a way to work our way over this side. Yeah, there's not really much to say. This section of the game is a lot simpler than you'd think it would be. And this here looks like some kind of Chozo statue thing, or whatever. Yeah, I don't really know what this thing is, exactly. I think it's supposed to, it's gotta be some kind of Chozo statue in some capacity. So yeah, this boss can be a little annoying. You have these things that are constantly shooting little projectiles here and there that are gonna knock you into these flower things that you don't want to get sucked up by. Take care. Not to run into that scenario here. And then, wouldn't you know it, this fight actually becomes easier once you get rid of those set flowers. So, just go Oonga Boonga on this thing, and that's really all she wrote, as far as this boss fight's concerned. Oh hey! We're already getting another beam, okay. But we haven't even had the wide beam that long. We've had it for like, what, two parts? Compared to like the four or five we've had the charge beam for? Whatever. This beam kicks ass anyway. You all know it. The plasma beam. Can pierce enemies, and I swear this is probably the coolest looking plasma beam in the entire series, because it's like... Just listening to it, it's like the most sci-fi ass sounding beam that I've ever heard out of any weapon that Samus has ever obtained in the series. It's weird. Plus, you don't have to worry about, like, it having freeze shot qualities, like, you know, having the ice beam stacked up on top of it normally would. But yeah, this thing kicks ass. So, like the description said, it pierces right through enemies. So even though you may not have killed an enemy upon killing it, or shooting it, rather, the beam just straight up goes right through them, unless it's like an armored enemy or something, which in that case, yeah, I don't know what to tell you. But yeah, the plasma beam is so kick-ass, and, oh yeah, remember when HQ had mentioned that, like, once you get the plasma beam, we have the ability to go after the SAX and fight it now? You know, that'd be a pretty good idea, all things considered. It'd be one less worry off of our back. We'll have to go back and tell him the news. Alright, cool, cool. Actually, I want to go back and take one of the other routes. To the entrance. Yeah, because this one... Yeah, we're not gonna worry about that route back. We're gonna take a different route, actually, because if we go this way, it's actually gonna take us to an expansion we can go ahead and get and not have to worry about on our excavation back towards the end of the game. And oh boy. Man, we really are getting closer to that point in the game, huh? I'm definitely not looking forward to that at all. Not at all. That's not where I wanted that. Oh, well, you know these guys mean business when even a power bomb won't kill off these things. Alright. You guys have had your fun. Can I stand right here? Cool! Two powerbomb tanks for the price of one! Who would have thought? Ow. Okay, I am getting a little bit too reckless here. Alright. Actually, you know what? I don't think there's really anything else we need from up here, so I guess we will take the other route back. Forget what I said, like, literally 5 minutes ago. Jeez. This beam is so awesome and kick-ass. Boy! So delicious! Oh, pfft. Thanks for ruining my moment of style. Oh my... Jesus Christ, this thing still hurt, even with the Mario suit equipped. What the foot? How'd we get 2 red X parasites from those bird enemies alone? Really doesn't make much sense at all, in hindsight. I actually want to see if we have the tools to check out this area. I forget if we do or not. Do we? Nope, nope. That's endgame stuff. Never mind. Alright, so yeah, we won't be coming back to Sector 2 ever again. Outside of, you know. You guys get the point already, Jesus. I'm not gonna sit there and reiterate myself. Alright, so let's fill up. Now that we have the power back online, we should be good to go. Hopefully the Experocytes aren't causing much more trouble than they've already caused. Well, yeah! What's up? I would have figured he'd be more excited about that. What the fuck? What makes you think that? I don't know, man. I'm pretty beefy now. What? There's just no moment to rest here, isn't there? We restored the power and all of a sudden— oh wait, more trouble! Fuck! The damage is staggering. That's a funny... like... it's a funny use of that word now that I think about it, because I was just... coming off of playing Tales of Vesperia Definitive Edition, which had just came out just recently. Maybe I should let's play a Tales game in the future. We'll have to see on that. But hey, we're playing Metroid, goddammit. Metroid is cool. Much more cooler than that waifu-ridden shit show that is Tales. Ugh. That literally does sound like a nightmare, by the way. Military applications. That's kind of shitty. I wonder if there was that creature we saw on the way back from both of our data room pickups, and it was just kind of hovering around in the background, just not minding its business whatsoever. Oh, and yeah, now we're coming to the point of where... objectives. Well, I mean, we kind of already dealt with that with the last one, but yeah, we're at a point where finding the objective feels a lot less linear now, because now they're not even really giving us the objective point or location anymore. Yeah, from this point forward, we're having to track down the thing ourselves with knowledge of the sector. And, yeah. Not really much more to say than that. Huh. Jesus, we were just here in the last part too. What the fudge, man? Also, can we open? Nope, that's endgame stuff. God damn it, fuck you, screw attack. Fucking screw attack barriers and your endgame shenanigan. Block offs and shit. Can he already foretell? Like, the big issue with the endgame collectathon. Have you noticed it yet? Is it clicking with you yet? Has it clicked with you yet? Because that's exactly what we're gonna have to deal with towards the end of the game. Ugh. Hope you're taking notes. And yeah, this thing just straight up destroyed the place. God fucking damn. I don't even think it kept the Arctic properties of the sector in place. Yeah, it just straight up destroyed the hatches. Everything's all melted and shit. Yeah, this thing's mean it's business. It's one thing to know about a monster causing havoc, it's another to actually see it wreck the shit out of the place. Oh yeah, and this. This may or may not be useful in our endgame expedition quest. Oh, fuck me. I never came back for this, did I? Oh, you know what? That's exact. God dang it. I never did go back to that, did I? That's exactly why we're missing E-Tanks that we shouldn't be missing. That right there. That's exactly why. Oh my god. I'm such a doofus. Jesus fucking Christ. And yeah, there goes our last data room. Or is it? Is it truly our last data room? Find out in the next exciting episode of Dragon Mount. But yeah. Looks like we're not gonna have our upgrades handed to us on a silver platter anymore. That's for damn sure. Yeah. come to a dead end. Except now we're in a point of no return. That's kind of shitty. So how on earth are we gonna actually get back once we beat this abomination? Alright, so let's see if we can lure this thing over here. Oh my god. Stop it. Stop. Stop! Oh wow, that was a lucky guess. I'm not even sure how the water didn't get into this room, but whatever. Alright. Hit up that E-tank for the reboot. Certainly gonna help this boss fight, because if anybody and their mom has ever played a Metroid game in their lives, then you'll know exactly what I'm talking about as far as, like, Nightmare is concerned, because, oh, well, man, we're just getting all of the good RNG, aren't we? How many Red X parasites have we run into just from normal enemy encounters alone now? Like, this shouldn't be happening. It shouldn't be happening at all. It's so weird. Like, stop it. Yeah, this water's actually kind of becoming a hassle now that I think about it. It's a little bit annoying. What is it with video games and their tendency to make water-based levels slower than molasses? What about that screams fun and exciting? I mean, it's not really that all that bad in this game's case, but it's like, why is it even there? I mean, realistically speaking, yeah, I guess it does kind of make sense, so. I don't even really know what I'm talking about anymore. Oh my god! These red X parasites, Jesus fucking Christ. Alright, so. If you really need it, you got a recharge station right here. Let's grab that power bomb expansion first before making any more moves. Yeah, we're just getting power bombs like it's candy, aren't we? It's like, oh, yeah, we kind of gave you these things a little bit late into the game. Let's just throw as many of them as we can at you, because why not? And no, telemarketers, I will not answer your pleas. Dang it, this is why I put my phone on vibrate during recording sessions. Ugh. Oh my god, the plasma beam is so awesome. It's so good! Fuck missiles! Plasma beam shots are the way of the future, my man. Oh yeah, and this is the trap, obviously. So, let's come around this way. Here we are. We're getting back on track with the E-tanks, kind of. And yeah, this thing right here is probably the hardest boss in the whole game, if only really because of the first phase. This thing here, this creepy motherfucking looking nightmare ass creature thing, this thing here is unfittingly called Nightmare. So what you want to do is that you want to shoot this thing, but shooting this thing if you're doing a minimalist run is easier said than done, because actually getting here and placing in safe shots is actually kind of difficult when you consider the fact that this thing slows down your movement really hard. And it makes it really annoying to get underneath them and place the shots in the first place. After that, though, it really makes me question why people thought this boss was hard from afterwards, after the first phase, because really, like, it's just another exploitable boss. So we want to make sure we get it in a position where it's facing this thing. Not right there, obviously. I mean, it does do a lot of damage, I won't deny that. Okay, this is not a good spot at all. So what you want to do is, as it's flying around like a fucking moron, you want to get it in a position where it's facing the wall, and then afterwards it's just gonna do this really lazy ass pattern here where it just kind of flies around with absolutely no additional animation. Like, I'm sorry, I love this game to death, and I love its presentation in a lot of areas, but that's just... it just looks so fucking lazy, dude. I'm sorry. Like, they could have given him an additional, like, sprite or something for that move, where he's just running around the room, or floating around it, rather, in the most, like, nonchalant way, it feels like. It's sure not giving me any ideal positions to shoot it from, though. God, dang it. Quit being an uncooperative little fuck. Let me destroy your face. Let me kick it in. Here. I mean, look at how many E tanks of damage it's already done to us. Oh my. Really? Jesus. Okay, on second thought, maybe this is why. I swear, I'm like getting the worst RNG with this thing. Okay, here we are. Alright. Eat that motherfucker. Get the fuck out of here. Oh, wow. It's a weird looking next parasite. It's all silver and shit. I mean, I don't know. I kind of like that color palette for it, honestly. It makes it look kind of cool. Even if unintentionally. Alright. See if we can get a good fatality on this thing.
Fatality.
Okay, not quite as cool as last time, but it'll do. And yeah, and we're starting to get to the point where these Core X parasites aren't really enough to fill up all of our HP now, isn't it? And yeah, we got the gravity suit. Thank the high heavens, because the Varia suit looks ugly as sin in this game, and you cannot convince me otherwise. But yeah, we got the gravity suit, and we can move freely in water now, and we got a cool color scheme and shit to go along with it. No, seriously, I think purple and green going along pretty well. In fact, I think purple and green are honestly my favorite colors now that I think about it. It used to be blue for the longest time, but now I've, like, every time I play fighting games or other multiplayer games or some shit, like, I'm always drifting towards purple and green colors as of late. And then you get this suit, and it's literally a combination that happens to be the best improvement for me. So yeah, I guess you could say, in a way, this suit sort of speaks to me on a personal level, which kind of sounds weird in hindsight now that I think about it, but... anywho. So, if anybody recalls within the past 5 or so minutes of us playing as we made our way over to the nightmare, you might have recalled that the route we took to get here in the first place, well, we can't really use that route to get back, so we're gonna need to kind of bend the rules to our liking a little bit and find a way out of here. I don't know why, but it feels so unsettling seeing space pirates swim around underwater like that. And this is the only game you see space pirates do that too, because in other games they're either just sort of chilling underwater with their base equipment as it is, or in the case of Metroid Prime, they actually had gear that allows them to hover around that end. But just to see him kind of, like, nonchalantly swimming around like a fish underwater like that, it's just... I don't know, it's something about that just kind of feels a bit off-putting, I won't lie. Yeah, this is not the route I expected to be taking, heading back to the navigational room, so... yeah, this is a little weird, a little bit off-putting, I won't lie. So, I guess we'll take the time to explore this fascinating-looking underwater haven. Oh my goodness, this is pretty goddamn beautiful. Bit mysterious too with that kind of music. You know, going in orchestration with this sort of environment, I suppose, but yeah. I guess we're just now venturing into the unknown now. This may or may not be a central theme that plays into effect with the narrative as we move further along from this point forward. Nudge, nudge, wink, wink. And now we have 200 missiles. Nice. Alright, I think that's enough detouring for right now. That's enough of a preview, I suppose. So, let's head up to that save station right there. And go ahead and hit that save button. And next time on Let's Play Metroid Fusion, we will head into the depths of this mysterious underwater research laboratory of sorts. And see if we can find a way back to the navigation room. So, see you guys then.